भारत स्वतंत्र झाला या घटनेला 2021 साली 74 वर्ष पूर्ण होत आहेत. या अमृत महोत्सवी वर्षाची सुरुवात आज 8 ऑगस्टला दीपपूजनाच्या मुहूर्तावर करूयात.
द सन वॉज अबाउट टू सेट, फिलिंग द अर्थ विथ डार्कनेस ऑल अराउंड. लुकिंग ॲट द डार्कनेस, समवन क्वेरीड, हू इज गोइंग टू लाईट द अर्थ? ॲट दॅट, अ स्मॉल स्टेडी लॅम्प लिट इन अ कॉर्नर आन्सर्ड, आय विल लिट अप, आय विल लिट अप. इन्युमरेबल सच लॅम्प्स केम इन टू एक्झिस्टन्स इन व्हेरियस नूक अँड कॉर्नर्स ऑफ इंडिया. फ्रॉम स्मॉल स्पार्क ऑफ लाईट they were transformed into huge ignited flames which returned the sunshine back to eclipse sun by sacrificing their lives. It was a fight against British army to maintain self-identity. In those days, India was well known for large production of various spices. East India Company developed Surat as a marketplace in 1617. It became imperative for East India Company to hold administrative powers in their hands with a view to enhance trade. At that time, India was made up of small princely states. After the Battle of Plassey in 1757, the Nawab of Bengal, Siraj Uddaula, was defeated by East India Company, which paved way for the company to enter into Indian politics. Almost the whole of South India went under the control of East India Company. After the defeat of Tipu Sultan, most of the small princely states were taken over by East India Company. Thus, steadily and gradually, East India Company was spreading its tentacles all over the Indian subcontinent. Velu Nachiyar was the first woman ruler who opposed the colonial rule of British East India Company. Velu Nachiyar was the princess of Ramanathapuram and the only child of King Chelumuthu Vijay Raghunath Setupati, queen of Sakandi Muthathal of Ramnad Kingdom. Her upbringing was just like a prince. She was trained in martial arts like sword fighting, archery, vallery, silambam and horse riding. She was proficient in not only Tamil but English, French and Urdu language. She married the king of Shivagangai with whom she had a daughter. When her husband was killed in the battle with East India Company and son of Arcot Nawab, she escaped from the battlefield with her daughter and went to Virupachi near Dindigul. Later on, Marathu brothers joined hands with Velu Nachiyar. Udiyal, bodyguard of Queen and her women warriors, stayed at Kalangudi to fight against the army of East India Company and Nawab of Arcot so that Queen could reach Dindigul safely. Nawab army captured Udiyal. They wanted to know whereabouts of Velu Nachiyar, but she did not utter a word. Angry Nawab executed Udiyal. Velu Nachiyar formed an all-women army in the name of Udiyal when she came to know the execution of Udiyal. The queen vowed that she will defeat the Nawab of Arcot and capture back the kingdom of Shivaganga to avenge the death of her husband and Udiyal. Meanwhile, Nawab of Arcot handed over the kingdom of Shivaganga in the hands of East India Company. With the limited arms and ammunition and trained personnel at her disposal, it was an uphill task for the single woman to fight against mighty British army. Marathu brothers formed army with the help of some loyalists, but it was not sufficient to fight against mighty British foe. At that time, Velu Nachiyar found an ally in the Nawab of Mysore Haider, who was very impressed with the Velu Nachiyar's proficiency in Urdu. The Nawab of Mysore was against the East India rule and also had requisite resources to aid the queen in her campaign against their common enemies. Haider Ali sent his army under the command of Sayyid Karki to assist the queen Velu Nachiyar. The queen, with her reinforced army, was successful in seizing parts of Shivaganga kingdom one by one and reached the gates of Shivaganga fort. Sayyid Karki told the queen Velu Nachiyar that it is impossible to seize the fort until the gate is breached. Quickly, one of her female warriors came off with an ingenious idea to enter the fort on the eve of Vijayadashmi. As there was a custom to allow commoners to enter the fort to offer obeisance to the deity in the form of fruits and flowers. As per the plan, the queen's associates, posing as a common people, entered the fort carrying baskets of flowers and fruits and hid weapons in the baskets and smuggled them inside the fort. They mounted a surprise attack. The British army was initially scared and taken unawares by the surprise attack. Queenie self-immolated herself in the room where the ammunition was stored. Thus, the British reserve of ammunition was destroyed and they were unable to counter-attack. This might be the first instance of human suicide attack in the history. Velu Nachiyar and valiant women warriors were successful in recapturing her kingdom. Velu Nachiyar reigned over the kingdom for the next 10 years. Later, she handed over the administrative responsibility to Malathu brothers. Queen's exceptional courage and valor led to the people coining her name Veeramangai. On 31st December 2008, Indian government printed postage stamp in the honor of Velu Nachiyar. On 18 July 2014, Honorable Chief Minister Jayalalitha inaugurated memorial of Velu Nachiyar and Kuili at Shivaganga. 3rd January is celebrated as birth anniversary of Velu Nachiyar in Tamil Nadu.